Okay, both of my dogs have something wrong. Batman has an open wound on the bottom of his jaw, and I got the bandage around it so it won't get infected or get dirty. I put some of this antibiotic spray on the wound, and I keep wrapping it every day to keep it fresh. But this guy right here, he just had an open wound on the side of his face that I never noticed it until now. And I don't know how he got it. I don't know where it came from. But you know, every time I try to wrap him, he tries to take the bandage off. So I'm sure that he's gonna do it when I'm not looking. Like when I went to go get my phone right now, I thought he was gonna take it off. But he hasn't messed with it so far. It's not on there really, really good, but all he got to do is start scratching on it with his nails, and he's going to pull it right off. So it's like an open, it's like a sore, or it's like, I don't know how it happened. So all I know is I can see his skin. It wasn't bleeding, but you can see that it may have bled before, and this is very recent. So I put like a little bandage there, just to catch the blood and just to keep it where I keep the medicine on there. But he don't know what's going on, so he's gonna probably, when I'm not looking, he's just gonna pull it off. But he's looking kind of pitiful right now. He's looking real strange. I mean, he looks with his eyes anyway, but with the bandage on his head, it looks like, and his ears back. Man, it's okay, man, you okay, you good. I just don't want those sores that they have to get infected. So he has, the bandage is going to shrink where it's located, because I can see that the sore is peeking out. So I just keep trying to pull it up. I tried to tape it, but I would need thicker tape. I would need thicker bandage tape. I have the right kind of tape. It just needs to be thicker in order to get it where his won't move. But I just keep wrapping it, that's all. I think I'm achieving the goal of keeping it clean and keeping it where it doesn't get further damage. But I think his came from having the collar around his neck. Not by me using the collar, but having the training collar around his neck, the prongs dug into his neck. I didn't have it too tight, but so that's why I'm kind of confused of how it happened. But the prongs actually, I don't know why, or it just irritated his skin. And it really nothing I can do about it. His skin could be a very sensitive under his neck, and having the collar there caused it, you know, to get further irritated. And you know, it was bleeding, but again, it wasn't tight. So that's why I'm confused, because I had their collars where they were not. They were almost loose, which they won't work too well if they're too loose. So I'm kind of confused of what happened there with the collar. So I took both of their collars and their chokers off. The choker didn't do it. You could tell that it was the prongs, but it wasn't me using it on them, because I had not used it on him. And remember, both of them had the same thing. So if it happened to him, it would have happened to the other, and it didn't. So I think he just have sensitive skin up under his neck, and it could have been there too long, meaning I didn't take it off. And so it can't stay there for too long. Whatever the case is, I'm hoping that it grows back, that his hair grow back, that everything goes back. And then I'll be more careful how long I keep the collar on there, because the collar is to prevent them from doing things that I don't want them to do. But they're not really bad dogs. It's not a lot of things that I try to stop them from doing. But he will try to attack him So I use it then, you know, but Smokey don't really do that much for me to need to use the collar on him other than when he's crying, when he doesn't need to be crying. But technically, they don't need their collar on them right now. So that's why I took the collar and the chains off right now. But Smokey just looking so pitiful with that, with the bandages around his neck. I feel bad for him because he know I don't want him to take it off. And he don't know what it is. He have no idea what that's there for. I mean, unless he felt me messing with, you know, messing with it. But he still doesn't know what the bandage is for. So it just, to him, it's just something that can irritate him and he want to take it off. So I'm sure that by the time I turn around and I start doing something, he's going to pull it off. Poor baby.